Hello children, I am Nisha here, your English teacher from Mangala Vidya Mandira. Hope you all are doing good. So children, in last class what we have learnt? We have learnt about parts of speech. So from this video, from today's class, we are going to start with the textbook syllabus. Let's have a look. What is the name of our textbook, children? The name of the textbook is Mary Gold, which is a NCERT based syllabus. So how many lessons are there? There are almost 9 lessons. Okay, so let's start with the first unit. The first unit, what is the name of the first unit? Wake Up, which is written by C. Fletcher. So in this unit, we will read and discuss about the poem Wake Up. So let's start reading the first stanza. Wake up, wake up. It's a lovely day. Oh, please get up and come and play. The birds are singing in the trees and you can hear the buzzing bees. Now, lovely means what, children? Lovely means a beautiful day. Buzzing means what? Making a low sound. Like the honeybees used to make a sound, a zzz, like that. That is called buzzing. So, in this stanza, the poet is asking the children to wake up and enjoy the beautiful day. See, all the children should get up early and go out and play. Even the poet is talking about the sound of birds, which is chirping on the trees, and the bees buzzing in the garden. You can hear that bees buzzing also, which you can hear in the garden. So, the first paragraph is over. Now, the second paragraph. Wake up, wake up, it's a lovely day. Oh, please get up and come and play. It's much too late to lie in bed, so hurry up, you sleepy head. So what do you mean by sleepy head, children? A child who likes to sleep for more time, who likes to sleep for long. So let me explain the paragraph. Here again the poet is asking the lazy children to get up, go out and play. The poet also speaks about the importance of timing. The poet says that it is too late to sleep now. The children should be punctual in life and everyone should wake up early. So children, remember always one thing. If you are punctual in life means you can be successful, which will be help you to be successful in life. Now the third paragraph. Wash and dress and come on out. Everyone is up and about. The cow, the horses, the duck and the sheep, the tiniest chicken, cheep, cheep, cheep. Wake up. Now in this stanza also, the poet is asking the children to get up ready. Okay, you get up and get ready and have breakfast, go wash yourself and wear some new dress. As all the creatures like duck, cow, horse, sheep and even the tiny chicks are awake now. So why you people are sleeping? You should also get up early in the morning and go out and play. Now here there is a similarity. What is like the, it is about similarity can be drawn between a tiny chicken and the rooster, whose crowing sound is considered to be as a natural alarm in the olden days. Because children, you remember in the olden days you won't be having a clock. There is no particular time, you cannot see the time because clock was not there. But this rooster sound, who will make a sound, this crowing sound, it is always considered as an alarm. It's a natural alarm in the olden days. So this is the three paragraph what we have read today. I will explain you one more time. Like in this poem, the poet is describing about the beautiful day to sleep, and it is not the time to sleep. Okay, you have to get up early and start playing. He is also asking the children to be very punctual in life. He has given importance to the timing and the punctuality. So hope children you understood the poem. Now let's move to the second sector. Okay, so now write in 200 pages, like you have to purchase 4-line notebook, 200 page, and the very first page you have to write A to Z, which is capital and small letter. The second page you have to write capital and small cursive letter A to Z. Now the third page, we are going to start with the textbook lesson. So the date you have to mention, at the same time unit number and the lesson name. The very first main is about keywords, which you have to write two times and you have to learn the keywords also. Let's have a look. The first one is singing. Number two, buzzing. Number three, sleepy. Number four, head. Number 5, horses. Number 6, chicken. Number 7, tiniest. Now the second main is about word meaning. Let's have a look, children. Buzzing means what? Making a low murmuring sound, making a low humming sound. The second one is tiniest. Tiniest means very small, very tiny. Any object, any creature, if it is small, we call them tiniest. Number 3 is lovely. Lovely means what? Beautiful. So children, hope you understood everything. Now let's start with the question answer, which is already given in page number 4 textbook. You can refer that. So first question is, what do you think birds say to each other in the morning? So children, what do you think? What did birds say to each other? The birds say good morning to each other in the morning. So the morning you wake up, as soon as you wake up, the very first thing, children, what do you say? You will say good morning. In the same way, even the birds are saying good morning to each other in the morning. Second question, who are already awake? Now, the question is about which all creatures are awake in the morning. So like birds, bees, horses, cows and chicken are already awake. Number 3, which creatures wake up in the morning before the child does? The creatures like birds, bees, sheep and chicken wakes up in the morning. So there are 3 questions where answer I have already mentioned in this PPT. Okay, now the last one is tongue twister, which you have to just say. You don't have to write in the notebook. Betty bought a bit of butter, but the bit of butter that Betty bought was butter. So Betty bought some better butter to make the bitter butter better, which you have to say fast. Okay, it's fast, almost 10 times you have to repeat. So children, today's session I'm going to conclude here. Remaining session will be continuing in the next class. So till then, thank you and be careful at your home.